What's going on, Halo fans? Luke the Notable here. In this video, we're going to be figuring out what it would take to get max rank in Halo Reach. Last week, I uploaded a video talking about what it would take to get max rank in Halo 3, and a ton of comments down in the comments section told me to do this video on Halo Reach. So grab your DMR and get comfy with some armor lock, because we're going to figure out what it takes to get max rank in Halo Reach. This video is sponsored by Amino. Amino is a super cool app on iOS and Android that allows you to build a community around the things that you love. Amino makes it incredibly easy to connect with other Halo fans out there in the world. With Amino, you can chat, post pictures, and even make quizzes to test your fellow Halo fans. Travis even took the time to post an official Travis G Money lore quiz. So if you think you know a lot about Travis, go test out your knowledge on Amino. There are links for both iOS and Android down in the description, so go check them out. And I also want to thank Amino for sponsoring this video. Now let's go find out what it takes to get max rank in Halo Reach. If you were able to reach max rank in Halo Reach, you would earn the title of Inheritor. Inheritor is a reference to the galactic mantle that Cortana is trying to get after in Halo 5. So amongst all of the humans and forerunners and elites fighting for the mantle, you, playing some Halo Reach, have earned the title of Inheritor just by playing a bunch. The Inheritor rank also allows you to unlock probably the coolest helmet in all of Halo. This spooky EVA variant that has a skull living inside of it. Basically, if you see one of these on the battlefield, you're boned. Get it? Little fun fact, through Make-A-Wish Foundation, the Haunted Helmet has been given out to a select few non-Bungie employees who have yet to reach the Inheritor rank. This helmet has been given as a special gift to those who are sick, disabled, and terminally ill, who also love to play Halo Reach. Kind of warms your heart looking into the soulless eyes of a dismembered skull. But how much would you have to play to earn the rank of Inheritor? It's actually very simple. To earn Inheritor, all you have to do is play for 100 days. Stay notable, guys. See you in the next one. Okay, so while playing for 100 days to get the max rank of Inheritor in Halo Reach is technically accurate, I do have to explain a couple things. The ranking system in Halo Reach used a credit-based system, so the XP that you got from winning games, playing Firefight, or even playing Campaign could be used not only to rank you up, but also to buy you armor. It was an incredibly cool system that I still think could work today in some fashion. Anytime I make a video on Halo 5's ranking system, there are always people down in the comments section that think that we should just go back to the way Halo Reach did it. But enough about that. In order to reach the Inheritor rank in Halo Reach, you had to amass 20 million credits. And many people don't know that there was actually a credit limit in Halo Reach. You could only earn 200,000 credits a day. And 200,000 credits a day is the updated credit limit. It used to be 120,000 credits a day. So if you take 20 million and divide it by 200,000, you get 100 days. Woohoo! But of course, I wouldn't be making this video if it was that easy. Getting to 200,000 credits is going to take a lot of grinding, and this video is going to explore the best ways to do that. So the first thing we're going to start out with is, what playlist are you going to play if you're trying to grind for the most credits in a given day? Because you have to get to 200,000 credits per day if you want to be most efficient. It's not like you can get 100,000 one day and then make it up another day by getting 300,000. If you don't hit that 200,000 mark, you're losing efficiency. So I played every playlist in the game, including all of the Firefight playlists, and I found out the average credit per hour for each playlist in Halo Reach. If you are going to grind for credits in Halo Reach, you essentially have two options. The fastest option in the game is Living Dead. That's the Zombies mode in Halo Reach. Living Dead offers about 13,000 credits per hour if you're winning a good percentage of your games, or at least coming near the top. If you're looking for a more casual and consistent method for getting credits in Halo Reach, Gruntpocalypse Firefight mode is the best way. Gruntpocalypse only gives you about 12,000 credits per hour, but it's insanely consistent. This type of consistency that Gruntpocalypse offers is going to be a lot better for players that aren't as good. For me, doing well in Living Dead is very easy, especially once I figure out where all the zombies spawn. I would have no problem grinding Living Dead and get max rank in Halo Reach. But for someone who's not as experienced with Halo, it's going to be much better for you to try out Gruntpocalypse. I had my girlfriend try out a couple games, and because she doesn't play a lot, she's out of practice, and she didn't do very well. Instead of averaging about 13,000 credits per hour with Living Dead, she only averaged about 9,500 credits per hour. And while playing Gruntpocalypse, she didn't do great, but she still got 12,000 credits per hour. Okay, those numbers are all good and well, but if we only averaged 13,000 credits per hour, we would still have to play 15 hours a day to reach the credit limit. Fortunately for us, there are other ways that you can earn credits in Halo Reach. The first is a credit jackpot. A credit jackpot will award you credits based on how many times that you actually finish out an entire game. It was an incentive put in by Bungie to reward players who finished out games and didn't quit out early. You can get anywhere from 3,000 to 20,000 credits from a single game with a jackpot. Now, of course, getting one of these things is insanely difficult. Even on Super Jackpot weekends, where the odds of getting a Super Jackpot were 100 times greater, there were people that still didn't get them, and they completed all of their games. So for us, counting on jackpots to help us reach the credit limit every single day is just not going to be a feasible option. Because the jackpots are so rare and Bungie has never released the odds of the jackpot, it is impossible to calculate how many we're going to get in a certain month or week or whatever. And if you think about it, if you get a super jackpot, the biggest there is, you're gonna get 20,000 credits. That's only about an hour and a half of playing Living Dead at my level, or about 2 hours playing Gruntpocalypse even if you're a noob. Ultimately, these super jackpots are really cool, but they're not gonna help you out a lot in your road to Inheritor. Another way to earn credits in Halo Reach is by completing commendations. There were three types of commendations: commendations for campaign, multiplayer, and firefight. Many of you may have boosted campaign commendations using a very common method at the time. The sad reality, though, of commendations is that they really don't do that much for you for credit. Sure, unlocking one can give you a boost here or there, but for the most part, getting them is very difficult and they don't give that many credits out. I mentioned campaign credit boosting earlier. That's what's on screen now. You might notice that I'm getting a ton of credits for every time that I revert my save, but this only lasts for a limited time. You're gonna get tens of thousands of credits, but only for one day, and it's not going to last you very long. In fact, even if you maxed out every single commendation in the game, the credits that you got from that would only equal about 4% of the total amount of credits you need to reach Inheritor. That's not that much, considering that a lot of the commendations are very hard to get. So yes, if it's your first day trying to grind all the way to Inheritor on Halo Reach and you're starting from level 1, it's a good idea to go and boost some campaign commendations. It's the fastest credit earning method in the game, but it only works for a limited time. After campaign commendation boosting runs dry, just focus on playing things like Living Dead or Gruntpocalypse. Playing Living Dead or Gruntpocalypse will allow you to get a ton of credits per hour, and you will passively earn commendations. Commendations are kind of a little boost every now and then, but they're not gonna help you reach your credit limit every day. Don't boost for them. And the last way you can get credits in Halo Reach is by completing challenges. There are daily challenges that reset every single day, and there is a weekly challenge that resets every week. Daily challenges are normally worth anywhere from 1 to 5,000 credits, and the weekly is normally worth around 20 to 30,000 credits. Unlike commendations, completing daily and weekly challenges are going to be very beneficial to you getting a ton of credits and reaching the rank of Inheritor. Completing all daily and weekly challenges will offer you about 10 to 15,000 extra credits for free every single day. And what's cool about challenges is most of the time you can get them by playing any of the normal playlists that you would play regularly. A lot of times they're either matchmaking, campaign, or firefight based. Okay, well now it's time to put all of this information together. How long would you have to play each day to reach the 200,000 credit limit so that you could reach Inheritor and get the spooky helmet in 100 days? So I assume that you're going to play every day and complete all of the daily challenges and the weekly challenges every single week. On average, doing that every single day will award you around 12,000 extra credits per day. Because you'll be playing a ton of Halo Reach trying to get Inheritor, especially if you're trying to max out and get to the credit limit every single day, let's just assume that you get a couple of jackpots a month. Now it would be very lucky for you to get two super jackpots and get 40,000 credits in a single month, but let's say you can do that. Getting those jackpots would offer you about 40,000 extra credits per month, or about 1,300 credits per day. And let's just for the ease of it say that during your grinding for Inheritor, you unlock and max out every commendation in the game. Now, if you were to do that, from all of those commendations, you would get 261,000 credits. Spread that equally over 100 days, and you're getting about an extra 2,600 credits per day. Now, with all of those very generous extra credits that I have calculated that you could get per day, you would still have to get 184,000 credits per day to reach the credit limit, which would still mean that you would have to play over 14 hours of Living Dead at my level just to reach the credit limit every single day. Let me be the first to say that it is possible. 14 hours a day still leaves 10 hours for sleeping, maybe even holding a part-time job. Unless you had some crazy part-time job or you were a Twitch streamer or a YouTuber that could somehow monetize the playing of Halo Reach, I don't think it's possible to support yourself while doing this. You would have to have someone supporting you, which if you want someone to support you while you play 14 hours of Living Dead a day, I just hope your mother is proud. But that is what it takes to get the Inheritor rank and the spooky helmet in Halo Reach. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if there are any Inheritors out there, please go down to the comment section below and let us know. You deserve to be recognized. A lot of hard work goes into Inheritor with all of the credit limits and how much you need to play and all of the ways that you can get credits. It's definitely one of the hardest max ranks to achieve in all of the Halo games. If you want to see more of these crazy analytical videos of everything Halo and you've never seen me before, please consider subscribing to my channel. I make tons of really cool Halo content that I think and know that you will enjoy. I want to thank every single one of you for watching. I want all of you to stay notable. And of course, I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.